from Studio 113 in Walson Hall. This is MBC News.
Hi, welcome to MBC News. I'm Alyssa Kratz.
And I'm Samantha Laskin.
So Sam, are you getting excited to register for classes for next year?
Yeah, I just registered for my clusters. I can't believe it.
That's so exciting. You're going to be a sophomore.
I know. And are you excited for junior year?
I am. I can't believe 2 years have already gone by. It's crazy how fast it goes.
That's amazing. So what's going on with the news this week?
I'll tell you. Sigma Phi Epsilon is hosting their first open party of the semester this Saturday, March 28th. The theme of the party is thrift shop, so head over to the local Salvation Army and get thrifting. The party will be held at the Sig Ep House from 10 p.m. to 2 a.m. It will be $2 to enter, and all proceeds will benefit Habitat for Humanity, a worldwide nonprofit organization which builds housing for those less fortunate. This party is an alcohol-free event. The Muhlenberg Theater and Dance and Music Departments are performing their second main stage production of the semester, Street Scene and American Opera, from Thursday, March 26th to Sunday, March 29th. Premiering on Broadway in 1947, Street Scene tells the story of the Hell's Kitchen neighborhood of Manhattan during the 1920s and the struggle of those who lived in it. The production features special guest artists Ed Barra and Lauren Curnow, a cast of over 50 students, and a 35-piece professional orchestra. Charles Richter, the production's director and professor of theater at Muhlenberg, spoke volumes of the show, saying that an opera of this scale has never before been seen in the Lehigh Valley. The shows on Thursday, Friday, and Saturday will begin at 8 p.m., and Sunday's show starts at 2 p.m. Tickets are $22 for adults and $8 for children and students, as well as all LaVey faculty and staff. Award-winning memoirist, novelist, and short story author Bernard Cooper will give a reading on Monday, March 30th at 7 p.m. in Miller Forum. This event is sponsored by the Muhlenberg English Department and is free and open to the public. A reception and book signing will follow the reading. Taking a look outside of the Muhlen bubble in world news, yet another tragic airline mishap occurred this past Tuesday as a German jetliner crashed in the southern French Alps midway through a flight from Spain to Germany. Announced Tuesday as the deadliest crash in France in decades, all 150 passengers on board were killed, including two babies and 16 German high school students and their teachers who were on their way back from an exchange trip to Spain. The Airbus A320 was operated by German Wings, a budget subsidiary of Lufthansa, Germany's biggest airline. The cause of the plane's descent is unknown, although the White House and the airline chief both stated that at this time there is no connection of the incident to terrorism. A black box was recovered from the crash site on Tuesday, and it will hopefully lend a hand as investigators search for clues and try to resolve the mystery of the crash. Lufthansa CEO Carsten Spohr called Tuesday the blackest day of their company's 60-year history, as the crash was the airline's first involving passenger deaths since the beginning of the airline's operations in 2002. Now, over to Sam with the Muhlenberg Sports Report.
Thanks, Alyssa. Last Thursday, the women's tennis team opened their season with an impressive win of 6-3 against Elizabethtown. Sophomore Sarah Finger and senior Jennifer Goldberg won at first doubles, and senior Sharon Reznikoff won three sets of singles. The Mules are ranked 20th in the league and are playing in this Saturday's Centennial Conference opener at Franklin and Marshall. The men's lacrosse team lost 6-4 to Franklin and Marshall last Saturday in their Centennial Conference opener. Seniors Michael Heenan and John Thomas scored for the Mules in the late first half of the game. This Saturday at Scotty Woods Stadium, come support your Fighting Mules as they verse Gettysburg at 1 p.m. This past week, the women's field hockey team received honors for their academic achievements at Muhlenberg. The Mules received Division III National Team Academic Awards for having a GPA of 3.0 or higher. 13 Mules were named to Division III National Academic Squad for achieving a cumulative GPA of 3.30 or higher. That's all for sports. Now here's Kevin with the weather.
Thanks, Sam. All right, so this week in weather, on Thursday, it's going to rain. High of 64, low of 42. 70% chance that it's going to do exactly what I just said. On Friday, it's going to rain in the morning, so on the afternoon, it should be pretty good. High 48, low 32, and 40% chance of rain. Saturday, it's going to be a partly cloudy day of high 37, low of 25, 10% chance of rain. Sunday, it's going to be sunny. Yes, the high of 48, low of 34, Let's see what's coming in on next week. And coming in right in on next week, on Monday, it's going to be a mostly cloudy day, a high of 54, a low of 36, 10% chance of rain. Tuesday, it's going to be a partly cloudy day, high 52, low 32, 10% chance of rain. On Wednesday, it's going to be a mostly sunny day, high 61, low 46, and a 20% chance of rain. So all in all, next week's looking pretty good. All right, back to you guys.
Thanks, Kevin. That's all for NBC News. I'm Alyssa Kratz.
And I'm Samantha Laskin. Have a great week, Muhlenberg.